This video goes with section 84 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers omicron contract verbs. Hansen and Quinn talks about this on pages 264 to 268. We're going to cover the basic concept of omicron contract verbs and then the forms that they take. If you're already familiar with the basic concept from our coverage of alpha contract and epsilon contract verbs, feel free to go on to the part where the forms actually start. Here's the verb you've known so long as our paradigm verb, luo, luso, elusa, leluca, lelumai, eluthane. And you know that all you have to do to get the stem from the first principal part is to take off the omega. Greek has another class of verbs whose principal parts go something like this, de lao, de loso, e de losa, de deloka, de delomai, e de lothane, in which if you take off the omega from the first principal part, you're left with a stem that ends in an omicron. Well, with lu as your stem, all you do is add the endings that you've learned for everything from the first principal part, no problem. But with de lao and other omicron contract verbs, as the name implies, you have to contract that omicron with the endings. And so this video will show you how to do that and the endings that result. This chart shows you all of the combinations for contractions with all three different vowels that happen in contract verbs. And we've now gotten to the final row, which are the omicron ones. Remember that each principal part is responsible for certain tenses in the various moods. Since contract verbs are only different in the first principal part, we're only going to have to worry about the things that happen with the first principal part. So let's think about what we're going to need to cover. We're going to have to deal with active, middle, and passive in the present and imperfect of the indicative, and the present tense of the subjunctive, the optative, the infinitive, and the participle. So let's get started. The rule, as usual, for the present indicative active is to take the first principal part and add the endings. So in each person and number, we'll need to have the omicron of the stem and the endings that we know. Then we need to figure out how to contract those. And here, I've got the part of the contraction chart that's concerned with omicron and the combinations. And you'll see that if we follow the guidelines below, those contractions result in o, ois, oi, umen, uta, and usi. The accents will be recessive, but with special rules for contracted verbs, which we'll go over in the next slide. So, let's see what this looks like with an actual verb. We can put in the first principal part stem from de lao, and then the endings that we know, but now we have to do the contraction. And the result looks like this. De lo, de lois, de loi, de lumen, de luta, de lucy. Now, those special contraction rules that I talked about for recessive accent. The rule goes that you do recessive accent as if it's on the uncontracted form, which looks like this, and then you do the contraction. And if the accent in the uncontracted form fell on one of the two contracted vowels, it stays on that vowel in the contracted form. And so the result is this. De lo, de lois, de loi, de lumen, de luta, de luci. Before we go on, notice that the regular way to say I make clear is de lo, but that in the paradigm or in the lexicon entry, you're going to say de lao. This is by convention because de lo wouldn't let you see that that's an omicron contract as opposed to an alpha contract or an epsilon contract. So again, by convention, we uncontract it in lexica and vocabulary entries. Let's go on now to present indicative middle passive, first principal part and endings, and of course we're going to have to contract them with the omicrons. So when we do the contraction, we get umai, oi, utai, umitha, ustha, and untai. Notice that with either of the versions of the second person singular, either eta with the iota subscript or epsilon iota, we still get the contraction oi. Again, the accent will be recessive with contraction rules. So here's what that looks like with an actual verb. There are your stems, the uncontracted endings, and contracted, they're going to look like this. When we put in the recessive accent on the uncontracted forms, they'll go there. So when we follow the rules for contraction and then adjust the accents, here's what we get. De lumai, de loi, de lutai, de lumitha, de lustha, de luntai. Now for the imperfect indicative active. Of course, now we need the past indicative augment, still the first principal part, and the endings. So with the omicron and the imperfect active endings, we'll contract this way. Un, us, u, umen, ute, un. And again, we'll be doing recessive accent with contraction rules. So in practice, that's going to be augmented stem plus endings, contracted to look like this, and then the accents are going to go on the uncontracted forms this way, so that the final pronunciation is going to be something like this. Edelun, edelus, edelu, edelumen, edeluta, edelun. Notice with the imperfect that many of the accents fall on a vowel that isn't contracted in the final form, and therefore it stays away from the contraction in the contracted form. The imperfect indicative middle passive, again, we're going to need the past indicative augment and the first principal part, and the omicrons with the endings that we know are going to contract like this. Umain, u, uta, umitha, ustha, unta. And again, it'll be recessive accent with contraction rules. So when we apply that to de lao, there are our augmented stems and the endings that we already knew, which are going to combine like this. Edelumen, edelu, edeluta, edelumitha, edelustha, and edelunta. Recessive accent with contraction rules means that I think about the accent on the uncontracted form and then make sure that if the accent fell on one of the two vowels in the uncontracted form, that it stays on the contraction in the contracted form. Now let's go on to the subjunctive. First principal part and endings. So here are the omicrons with the endings that we know, and now let's do the contraction. We get o, ois, oi, omen, ota, osi. Again, we'll have that recessive accent with the contraction rules. So with de lao, that's going to be de lo, de lois, de loi, de lomen, de lota, de losi. And the accent is going to come out like this, which I hope I pronounced. The present subjunctive middle passive, again, first principal part and endings. So omicrons and the endings that we know, which, after the contractions, become omi, oi, otai, omitha, ostha, ontai. Recessive accent with contraction rules once we apply it to an actual verb. So let's do that. There are the stems from the first principal part of de lao, and the endings of the subjunctive middle passive that we already know. And once we contract that, they'll look like this. And when we put the recessive accent on the uncontracted forms and then apply the contraction rules, we'll get de lomai, de loi, de lotai, de lomitha, de lostha, de lontai. Now it is time for the optative. First principal part and the endings. So in this case, we're going to have to know how to contract the omicrons with the optative active endings that we already know. So we do the contraction, and we're going to get oimi, ois, oi, oimen, oite, oien. Pretty familiar. Now, the thing about the optative active in contract verbs is that we have all these alternate endings. So we're also going to get, I remind you that these will have recessive accent with contraction rules, we're also going to get those pesky alternate endings, oyen, oyes, oye, oyemen, oyete, oyesan, which I have now already pronounced in the contractions that they do with omicron contracts, because omicron and oi becomes oi. So let's look at all of that with de lao. So there's our stem, there are the endings, and they become de loimi or de loien, de lois or de loies, de loi or de loi a, excuse me, de loimen or de loiemen, de loite or de loieta, and de loien or de loiesan. Now, recessive accent goes on the uncontracted forms like this, and finally on the contracted forms in this way. This is perhaps the time to tell you that omicron contract words have an unusual number of overlapping forms. For instance, de loi can be third person singular indicative active, third person singular subjunctive active, or third person singular optative active. De loi can also be second person singular indicative middle and passive, and second person singular subjunctive middle and passive. So if you'll notice, that's actually seven different forms that one spelling can be. Not only that, de lois can be the second person indicative active, the second person subjunctive active, and the second person singular optative active. Lots of possibilities that you'll have to allow for. Now, the present optative middle passive, again, first principal part and endings, so we'll need the omicron and the endings that we know, and do the contraction, and you'll get oimein, oia, oita, oimitha, oistha, ointa, and no alternate forms this time, and recessive accent with contraction rules. So, with de lao, that's going to be these stems and those endings, which are going to contract in this way. And we're going to put recessive accent on the uncontracted forms, which means that our final forms will be de loimein, de loia, deloita, deloimetha, deloistha, deloita. Now, let's do the present infinitive active. It's going to be the first principal part and the infinitive ending. In this case, it's like the alpha contract infinitive, where we have to remember that the epsilon iota nu ending that we learned first for present infinitive active is actually in and of itself a contraction of two epsilons. So when we contract the omicron with the epsilon here, we're going to get un as our present infinitive active ending for omicron contract verbs. That means when we put it on the stem that we have from de lao, our final form is going to be de lun. Recessive accent with contraction rules means that it's going to look like this, de lun. The present infinitive middle passive, first principal part, and the ending that we know, which is going to contract to be usthai. And so with de lao, we're going to get de lusthai. Now we need to do participles. It's going to be the first principal part and the endings that we know, so omicron and on, usa, on, which, after you contract them, becomes on, usa, un. So with de lao, you're going to get de lon, de lusa, de lun. Recessive accent with contraction rules, and that means we put that accent recessively on the masculine, feminine, and neuter there, except that we get the accent and its persistentness from the masculine nominative singular, so it wants to be on the omicron all the way through, which means it's on the contraction all the way through in all three genders of the nominative. That results in stems and genitive singulars that look like this, de luntas, de luces, de luntas, which means that the stems for the rest of the declension of the present participle active is de lunt, de luce, and de lunt. The present participle middle passive is a little simpler, as you know. It's first principal part and endings. So omicron plus ominos, omine, or ominon, which means uminos, umine, uminon. With our verb, we need to do the contraction, and we get de luminos, de lumene, de luminon. Our recessive accent with contraction rules will end up there. That's a brief but I hope thorough treatment of omicron contract verbs, which you ought to be able to handle now when you run into them.